When you open Scribus, you are welcomed by the new document window. You can click on Open Recent Document if you want to proceed working with an existing document. But we will create a new document. Standard you will get a single page, in A4 size and in millimeters. But you can change this. You can, for example, choose letter when you are not in Europe, and work in inches. In fact, you can give in any size, to define the dimensions you are going to be printing on. You can set the number of pages, but you can also do this later. We will look at facing pages at a later point, which is when you create a book or magazine. When you have defined the dimensions of your paper, you can optionally create margin guides. Margins is the purple rectangle that we defined in Lecture 3. Although you see a purple line, this purple line will not be printed. The margins are only there to visually show you the distance to the edge. Texts are normally not placed outside the margins and never against the paper edge, except for creative reasons. Images, however, can go up to the paper edge. And this is where bleeds come in. Bleeds are meant for professional print. Your home printer does not print outside your paper. Professional print, however, does print outside your paper. It prints on a paper size that is a bit larger than your final paper size. What is printed outside the paper is cut up with a knife. This is done so that it is possible that images that you have placed up to the edge of the document do not end up showing white paper stripes at the paper edge. That would look very unprofessional. So images that touch the paper edge must be also be placed just for a few millimeters outside your document. We will look at this later in the course. In the next lecture, we will start working with the elemental building blocks of graphic design, placing frames.